In this lesson, I will show you how to import various objects, such as furniture, into SketchUp via 3D Warehouse. 3D Warehouse is an online SketchUp community where several users can upload objects they have created or download objects created by other users. If you do not want to waste time creating furniture from scratch, you can browse 3D Warehouse and find what you need. To open 3D Warehouse, you can expand the window menu and select the 3D Warehouse option. Alternatively, you can click on the 3D Warehouse icon, which you can easily find in the toolbar on the left. Once I click on the icon, the 3D Warehouse window appears. The 3D Warehouse can be accessed by simply creating an account using your email address and a password the first time that you launch it. After logging in once, every time you open the 3D Warehouse window, you will be logged in. I should also mention that for the objects and options to appear in this window, it is necessary to be connected to the internet. Now, I'll maximize this window to see its options clearly. At the top left of the window, certain icons appear. If I click on the left arrow icon, then the previous page will be displayed, and if I click on the right arrow icon, then the next page will be displayed. Now, if I click on the home icon, the home page of the window will be displayed. You can also go back to the home page by clicking on the 3D Warehouse image. Below those icons, there is a search field in which you can type a keyword to search for objects. However, to the left of this field is the All Categories drop-down, from which you can select a specific category of objects. On the right of the window, the Upload a Model icon appears. If you click on it, you can upload an object that you have created on your own so that it will be available for download by other users. Next to this icon, the Profile icon appears, from which you can manage your profile. In the middle of the window, several objects created by other users appear. Now, let's move on to an example. Suppose I want to insert a bed in the bedroom of the model I have created. I will click on the search field, type the word bed, and press enter. Notice that once I pressed enter, all the bed objects that were found in the 3D warehouse appeared. Since there are quite a few results, we can filter which of them will appear on the left side of the window. The filters we use most often are the file size filter, where you select the objects to display based on their size, and the polygons filter, which refers to how many polygons the mesh of the object will consist of. I should mention here that the more polygons the mesh of an object has, the denser the mesh, and the bigger the size of the file. If I expand the advanced options, I can add more filters if I want. I will search the results to find the bed I want, and I will click on it. Once I click on it, the preview is enlarged, and we can also see more information about the object, such as its materials, polygons, the size of the file, and the date it was last modified. To import it into the model, I just need to click on the download icon. Automatically, a message appears asking me if I want to import the object directly into the file or if I want to save it to my computer. If I select yes, the object will be imported directly into the model, and if I select no, it will be saved on my computer. In this example, I will select yes. Notice that the object is being downloaded, and as soon as the downloading process finishes, the 3D warehouse window closes, and the bed appears in the scene. I'll click to place it. Now using the editing tools, like the Move tool, the Rotate tool and so on, I can place it where I want. I will activate the Move tool to move it inside the second floor's bedroom. I can follow the same process to place more objects in the scene. So, in the same way, I will place a table. I will click on the search field and type the word table. I will click on products and select a dining set. Then I will click download and select yes. Finally, I will click to place the object in the right position. Before we finish the lesson, I should mention that it is advisable to create a folder and save the objects you download there to create your own library over time.